Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers the first half of section 1.1, Systems of Linear Equations. We'll talk about fundamentals of systems of linear equations, the three types of solutions to a linear system, and all about how to write linear systems in matrix form. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use while you watch this video. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the concepts that we'll go over and fill out the answers to the examples we're going to do. A linear equation is an equation that can be written in the form a1x1 plus a2x2 all the way up to anxn is equal to b. The variables in the equation are x1, x2, all the way up through xn, and the coefficients are a1 all the way up through an, and b from the right-hand side. The coefficients can be either real or complex numbers. To understand linear equations better, it's helpful to learn what terms may be in an equation that is nonlinear. A nonlinear equation may have roots, powers, or products of variables. These could look like the square root of x1, x1 squared, or the product x1, x2. A nonlinear equation may also have arguments of trigonometric, exponential, or logarithmic functions. These may look like sine of x1, e to the x1, or ln of x1. Let's now look at some examples and determine if these three equations are linear or nonlinear. In our first example, our two variables, x1 and x2, are only raised to the first power, so this is a linear equation. In our second example, we have cosine x, and this makes this equation a nonlinear equation. In example 3, we have a product of variables x2, x3, so that equation is a nonlinear equation. In this course, we're going to be working with linear equations. Let's now talk about a system of linear equations. A system of linear equations is a collection of two or more linear equations involving the same set of variables. This is an example of a linear system of equations. And in this example, we have m equations. Let's go ahead and highlight that. And we have n variables or unknowns, and we'll highlight that. A system of linear equations can also be called a linear system of equations. Let's now talk about solutions of linear systems. We're going to learn what a solution looks like and how many solutions we can have. A solution of a linear system is just a list of numbers when substituted back into the equations, make each equation true. We can write an equation as an ordered list of values, and we can call them S1, S2, all the way up through Sn. Or we can write our solution explicitly and write it as X1 is equal to S1, X2 is equal to S2, all the way up through Xn is equal to S sub n. To determine if a list of numbers is a solution to a linear system, we need to substitute those numbers back into the linear system and see if the number that we get on the left side of the equation matches up with what's on the right. In this example, we're given a linear system with two equations and three unknowns and asked to determine if these two points are solutions to the system. For our first point, we're going to substitute negative 2 back into x1, 5 into x2, and then 8 into x3. Let's go ahead and do that. We have 2 times minus 2 minus 3 times 5 plus 5 times 8, and we'll see if it equals 21. This gives us minus 4 minus 15 plus 40 on the left and 21 on the right. Minus 4 minus 15 plus 40 is 21. So our left-hand side agrees with our right-hand side. We need to remember to plug the solution back into all the equations. If we substitute minus 2, 5, and 8 back into our second equation, in the same way that we did for our first equation, we're going to get a minus 34 on the left, which agrees with our minus 34 on the right. And this tells us that minus 2, 5, 8 is a solution to our linear system. So let's mark this with a yes. We're going to do the same thing with our second point. We'll plug 6, 2, and 3 back into our first equation, and we get 21 on the left, which matches up with 21 on the right. However, when we plug 6, 2, and 3 back into our second equation, we don't get minus 34 on the left. Instead, we get a minus 19, which is not equal to minus 34. So this point is not a solution to our linear system of equations. Before we start talking about the number of solutions a linear system can have, I want to point out two or more definitions that will help us throughout our course. A solution set of a linear system is the set of all possible solutions to the system. Equivalent linear systems are systems with the same solution set. We'll soon learn that we can solve a linear system by creating an equivalent linear system that's easier to solve, and it will have the same solution set. Let's now talk about the types of solution there can be to a linear system of equations. A linear system of equations can have no solution, exactly one solution, or infinitely many solutions. There are no other possibilities. We're now going to go over an example that will help us understand this through a geometrical perspective. We have 3 linear systems of equations, and we want to determine the number of solutions for each. I'm going to graph these equations on an app called Desmos. You can see from Desmos that our first linear system contains 2 parallel lines. These lines never intersect, so this linear system has no solution. Let's now look at our second example. Desmos shows us that these 2 lines intersect. So we can write that this linear system has 2 intersecting lines. These lines intersect at one point, so there is one solution. Let's now look at our third example. In this example, our second equation is a multiple of the first equation. You just multiply the first equation by 4 and you get the second equation. Because of this, we have 2 identical lines. These 2 lines intersect at every single point, so we have infinitely many solutions. Since 2 lines will either be parallel, will intersect, or will be identical, you can see how there are only 3 possible types of solutions. Let's now look at this chart and learn some more terminology about what we call a linear system when it either has no solution, exactly one solution, or infinitely many solutions. When a linear system has no solution, we say that it's an inconsistent linear system. If a linear system has exactly one solution or infinitely many solutions, we say that the linear system is consistent. We'll now turn our attention to learning some fundamentals about matrices. A matrix is a rectangular array of numbers, such as the A's that are listed here. This matrix contains M rows, and it contains N columns. When we talk about the size of a matrix, we need to list the number of rows first. So for this matrix, we say that the size is M by N, because M is the number of rows and N is the number of columns. Aij is the entry in the ith row and jth column. For example, A12 is the entry in the first row and second column. Let's now understand more about this, and let's look at an example. We're asked to determine the size of the following matrix. This matrix has 3 rows and 4 columns, so we would write the size as 3 times 4. Matrices are used to represent data, and they're also used to write a linear system of equations compactly and solve it efficiently. When working with linear systems of equations, there are 2 types of matrices: a coefficient matrix and an augmented matrix. A coefficient matrix, down here at the bottom, contains the coefficients from the left side of the linear system. An augmented matrix contains the coefficients from the left side of the linear system and from the right side. We often will add a fictitious line to an augmented matrix to help us remember that we have a left side and a right side. When you're working with matrices, if you have a matrix and you're not told if it's coefficient or augmented, you are to assume that it's a coefficient matrix. Let's now put into practice what we just learned and walk through 2 example problems. In our first example, we're going to write the coefficient and augmented matrices of this linear system. The coefficient matrix will just contain the coefficients from the left-hand side of the equation. Those coefficients are 1 and 3 and minus 2 and 2. And then the augmented matrix contains the coefficient matrix 1, minus 2, 3, 2, and it contains the right-hand side, which are the coefficients 1 and 11. I had a student ask in class the other day, what would happen if we don't have an x1 or an x2 in an equation? For example, say we have just minus 2x2 is equal to 1, and then 3x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 11. We would have to put a 0 here to indicate that we don't have an x1. So this 0 would go into this position. In this second example, we're going to do just the opposite. We're given an augmented matrix, and we want to write a linear system that corresponds to it. You can choose the variables to be any type of letter, and I'm going to choose them to be x1 and x2. We have 2 variables because we have two columns on the left-hand side. We can write this first row as minus x1 plus 3x2 is equal to 4. And then our next row gives us 6x1 plus 5x2 is equal to 10. And then our last row gives us just 2x2 is equal to 8. We don't have an x1 because we have a 0 in that position. In the next video in this series, we'll learn how to solve a linear system of equations, learn all about elementary row operations, and how to determine if a linear system is consistent or inconsistent. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.